On 25 May 1963, our forebears and the founding leaders of our continent of Africa gathered in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, to found and launch the Organization of African Unity, the OAU. It was a historic occasion which unfolded at a time when only a handful of African countries on our continent had broken free from the shackles of Western colonialism. In our case, Zimbabwe was at that time 17 years away from its independence and freedom, which only came on 18th April 1980. The launch of the OAU marked the forging and the formation of a critical instrument for African solidarity against oppression and would result in the speeding up of the decolonization program and the establishment of new nation states on the continent. This year, we mark 57 years since the founding of the OAU, which later transformed into the African Union in 2002 to accelerate and deepen economic and political integration. Let this year's celebration serve to remind us all of the sacrifices made by the thousands living and departed, brave sons and daughters of our continent who took up arms to end colonial rule. They are the heroes of our lands, heroes of Africa. As we commemorate Africa Day for us in Zimbabwe, we are reminded that we were not alone in the struggle for our independence. Africa stood by us. Unity and solidarity was at the cornerstone of our victory. As the late Julius Mwalimu Nyerere said, and I quote, "Without unity, there is no future for Africa," end of quote. Indeed, in the case of Southern Africa, that African solidarity and unity was decisive under the organized and determined coordination of the frontline states. This was a resilient coalition of pan-African sister republics who faced head-on the vicious colonial and apartheid forces until the freedom of South Africa in 1994. Now, almost the whole continent of Africa has been rid of colonialism and apartheid, with the exception of Western Sahara. Zimbabwe continues to reaffirm its position on the right of Western Sahara to self-determination. The cruel dispensation of occupation and exploitation of a people by another, organized as foreign occupying powers under whatever guise, must be permanently expunged from our continent. As we celebrate Africa Day, we are jubilant that the vision of our founding fathers has been by and large realized, kept, and is jealously defended. Above all, that vision continues to be elaborated upon, notably through Agenda 2063, which envisions an economically integrated continent of Africa, which will be a global powerhouse by 2063. Our continent's desire is to achieve sustainable development through concrete manifestations of the pan-African drive for unity, self-determination, freedom, progress, and collective prosperity. To this end, the African Continental Free Trade Area, a CFTA, has now come into force and seeks to ensure a brighter and a more prosperous future. It is therefore imperative for us to scale up our integration and cooperation at all levels in our quest to realize food security and to mitigate the impact of climate change and the ever-increasing threats posed by disease outbreaks. Conscious of Agenda 2063, we must continue to explore and exploit our vast natural resources, the value addition and the beneficiation of our various resource endowments must be harnessed to modernize and industrialize Africa's economies. In this decade of action, let us give impetus to innovation. We must drive all facets of socio-economic development, leveraging on science, technologies, as well as our rich heritage, history, and cultures. In doing so, the promotion of human development and the economic empowerment of all our people, especially the youth and women, must result in an Africa that produces goods and services for itself through its own innovations and initiatives. The realization of sustainable development and the great vision of an improved standard of living for our people must remain a top priority. Furthermore, we must continue to consolidate and deepen the culture of democracy and good governance bequeathed to us by our founding fathers. We cannot be taught democracy by those countries which unleashed colonialism against us. We are our own liberators. We fought and sacrificed the lives to achieve democracy which we enjoy today. Let us never shy away from expressing our rich cultural heritage, language, and unique identities. The African diaspora remains an integral and inseparable part of us. Their skills and competencies must be harnessed for the good of the continent. This was the great vision of the luminaries of our great continent. Here in Southern Africa, we continue to make rapid strides towards regional integration under the auspices of SADC. To date, Zimbabwe continues to pursue robust cooperation with our neighbors and the continent as a whole, subscribing to a fully integrated continent of Africa. We must now urgently consolidate the implementation of cross-border projects to improve our road networks, water, energy, and ICT infrastructure, among others. This will inevitably accelerate multifaceted sustainable development in the region and on the continent. Fellow Africans, despite the strides made to date, our continent is still beset by multiple challenges, with the guns still to be silenced in some parts of Africa. In addition, new existential challenges such as terrorism threaten the peace, security, and stability of the continent. Recently, the extraordinary SADC organ Troika Summit met to address this very scourge which has caused grave suffering. Let me reiterate our unequivocal rejection of terrorism in all its forms and manifestations, and our strong condemnation of all terrorist acts, which will never be justified. Zimbabwe remains committed to play its part in all regional and continental initiatives as our modest contribution towards a prosperous and peaceful world order. Meanwhile, neo-colonialism still raises its ugly head, with some Western countries unashamedly meddling in the internal affairs of countries on our continent. Zimbabwe is no stranger to this unwarranted interference. We continue to endure illegal sanctions and punitive measures imposed on us as punishment for reclaiming our land, itself a key act of concluding the decolonization process. However, we are buoyed by the fact that we have reunited with our land, which is now irreversibly reposed into our hands. We its true owners. As we commemorate and celebrate the unity of our continent, we in Zimbabwe deeply thank our SADC region and the whole continent of Africa for standing with us. Africa has rejected and denounced the sanctions against Zimbabwe and the Sudan, urging those responsible for these illegal, heinous measures to immediately lift them without conditionalities. They are illegal, unjust, spiteful, and undeserved. Above all, they go against the grain and the spirit of civilized international relations as espoused in the United Nations Charter. We reiterate that sanctions have no place in modern international relations. Fellow Zimbabweans and fellow Africans, today we face a new and invisible threat to Africa and the world, that of the COVID-19 pandemic. While Africa still has comparatively low levels of infections, this virus is a grave existential threat and an attack on every facet of our lives and economies as a continent. We must therefore continue with the concerted efforts towards a continental response and a united global response under the World Health Organization. COVID-19 knows no borders, hence our response both on the continent and beyond must reflect this undeniable reality. Let me conclude by urging us all to keep the faith and the vision of our founding fathers. Let us all unite and celebrate together the victories won for our liberation, rededicating ourselves to forever defend our liberty and unity. We must equally commit ourselves to fight together for lasting justice and sustainable development, which leaves no one behind. As children of this country and of the continent, let us commit to play our part and cause new light to dawn upon the human race. In the words of our continental anthem, "Sons and Daughters of Africa," let us make Africa the tree of life and a fully integrated continent which is home to all, as well as a haven of peace, love, stability, and tranquility. Long live Africa, long live African freedom and solidarity. Long live the vision of our founding fathers. God bless Zimbabwe. God bless Africa. I thank you.